Hey, Vikings! Welcome back to the playthrough! As you can see, we are picking up where we left off from our previous episode. We are sailing around to the Elder's Island, the Elder being the boss of the Black Forest. We discovered their boss location, and it was a little bit further away from where our current Black Forest zone was. Just literally looks like it's just around the corner from that northern mountain that we discovered as well. But we are sailing to it, as I do believe it is on a different island. I'm pretty certain that it is anyway. So we are sailing over to place a portal down, get a little area walled off so that we've got somewhere that we can come back during the fight if we ever need to leave. Or if we die. Fingers crossed we don't. And you also might remember from our previous episode, we were also in the process of smelting down all of our copper and tin from our recent big gathering session that we did when we carted it all back. So we will be on with making our upgrades as well. Hopefully, we'll get on with that at some point this episode, maybe. Depends on how well we do in terms of the smelting. I believe when we left it off last, we were pretty much done with all the copper and we just had all the tin to do. So we're pretty close to having that done too. Oh, there's a little river intersecting these two islands. That's quite nice. That means we can pretty much sail right up to where his boss, like, arena is. Oh, there's even a shipwrecked boat there. Is that a shipwrecked boat? Yeah, it is, yeah. Oh, nice. Left of the screen looks like an old boat that's broken down. If we were to cut that down, we'd get fine wood. Just gonna pop the boat there. Look at that. Like a glove. Grab all the portal materials. Eat some more food, because we definitely need to make sure we've got health and stamina for being around here. Just in case we get attacked by any trolls. Not really fussed about the Grey Dwarfs, unless maybe level 2, but even then, really not that fussed. Now, pretty much right in front of us there, if you see those pillars in the fire, that is our... That's not a fire, the fire's in the middle. There it is. This is our boss arena for the Elder. This is the same as Eikthyr's boss arena, but this one just has a bit more decoration to it. There's a big fire in the middle where we have to make our offering, and there is the hint stone that I like to call them. Burn their young. So, as you can guess, the young for the Greylings are the ancient seeds that we've been picking up when we've destroyed their nests. So we've killed the shaman and the brutes. They've been dropping these green ancient seeds. That's the item we need in order to summon the Elder. Now, again, the same with Eikthyr. I cannot remember, for the life of me, how many of these seeds that you need. I'm pretty sure it's 3 or 4, but we'll find out when we actually get to doing the boss himself. Now we just need to kind of locate a decent enough area that's close enough to the boss's, like, summoning part that we can portal back quickly, but not too close that it's going to attract any attention from him if we do die. I think around here is actually not too bad, if I'm honest. But we are going to need to cut some wood down in order to gather, in order to build some walls around it as well. We are going to need that. Is that a troll? Yep, that's a troll and he's seen us, so we're just going to have to... Pew pew. Oh, we missed our second shot. Our first shot did a fair amount of sneak damage to him, though. I guess he took issue with us chopping that tree down. Nope. Just gonna poke him to death. I also feel a bit bad for the troll, because if you look exactly where we're poking, that's not exactly the nicest area on the body that you can be poked. Especially for a troll, because it's literally right where his crotch would be, so... Technically just skewering his nuts. Sorry, Mr. Troll. But apparently it's your weak spot. The other thing as well is that, the other thing that kind of annoys me as well is that how easy it is for me to take on a troll like this. I'm actually fighting a troll. I want to kill him. How easy it is for me to just step back and avoid his swing there. I didn't even have to dodge roll for that. I just stepped back and missed it. And, you know, don't get hit by any of his attacks. But when we actually need to avoid his attacks and focus on doing that, that's when I die to him. I suppose that's, a mistake of my own making. Now you've sat down for us as well. Give me your leather so that we can take it back and upgrade some more. Give me all the gold coins too. Gonna need a lot of these gold coins when we eventually find the merchant. Now this does seem to be a fairly reasonably sized Black Forest biome. At least it seems to be pretty big. At least from initial contact it seems alright. Certainly seems a lot bigger than our original one that we were farming for tin and copper. There's a lot of Grey Dwarfs around here. Ooh, we are taking some damage. We have to be careful. And our stamina's run out. And we haven't got rested. Oh, ouch. This brute is going to bash our heads in if we're not careful. But the annoying part is that he's... Oh, God. We're parrying his attacks, but he's draining all our stamina when we're parrying, so we haven't got any stamina to take up the follow-up swing on him. Get parried.
Then blocked. Come on.
And then obviously the spawner behind us is constantly spitting out more Grey Dwarfs, so we need to take it down as soon as possible. Oh god, two Shaman at once. Shaman, whatever. Spellcasters. Or fart casters, because that's what they pretty much do in our direction. They just fart at us. They fart at you, it hurts. If they fart in the air, they heal. Although they don't really heal us. Oh, another Shaman. Shaman. And it's night time. Jesus. Really, I'm quite surprised at how easy the Grey Dwarfs are. How easy I make them look. I suppose, I think I've already said this, I've probably already mentioned it in a previous episode, but the thing with Grey Dwarfs is, even in high numbers of just standard Grey Dwarfs, they're not dangerous. They're just annoying. Like, Grey Dwarfs even, like, if you remember back to our episode where we were initially starting our mining in that Black Forest biome for the copper, and we had to set down all those campfires, and we had about 8 Grey Dwarfs running around that were... not attacking us because they were afraid of the fire, but they didn't want to run away either, so they were just kind of swarming constantly. Even they weren't that dangerous. Even when the Shaman and the Brutes first showed up, they weren't worrying. I'm guessing it's just that I've played through Valheim so many times, and I've started so many new worlds, and I've run the Black Forest hundreds of times, that I'm just so used to fighting them that they're not really a worry anymore. Even if I've got low health or low level armor or a bad shield or something, I'm still not that concerned by them. Anyway, we are just going to pop home quickly, heal ourselves up, dry off, and sleep through the night. There we go. Oh. Stood up by accident. There we go. Something to be aware of, especially if you're using controller when you're getting into bed. When you press the button, try not to press anything else whatsoever. Don't even look around with your mouse or your left stick, because your right stick, your right stick on control. I'm getting my controls mixed up, because if you press any button, if you say accidentally press the forward button for W or press forward on your left stick, your character will just stand up, but they'll kind of like teleport into the bed but then stay stood up. They won't lie down. Alright, dump the inventory. Grab some more food. I'd really need to remember that I keep dumping the honey back in that chest, even though we want to keep it. Quickly top it all up again and head back through to this one. We now have a working portal system number 2. As far as I'm aware on Valheim, there is no limit to portal systems that you can have. I believe, again, if you change the world settings, you might be able to set a limit or something like that. But in just standard gameplay, if you don't change the world settings whatsoever, there is no limit to portals. You can have as many of them as you want. And now we're just going to cut some trees down and prep for building these walls around this portal so we can keep it protected. Ooh, there's some carrot seeds. Yeah, nice. Definitely use some more of those. Hopefully we can find some... oh, hello. Literally just thinking, hopefully we can find some burial chambers. Then a skeleton appears, so that means there probably is a burial chamber nearby. They don't usually just appear out of nowhere. Okay, yeah, let's get cracking on building these walls. Probably gonna need a bit more wood first, though. Not sure why I want a pickaxe out. We could try and chop a tree down with a pickaxe. It'd probably take us a long time, though. I'm not going to cut these trees down as I don't really need that much wood right now.
What the heck?
Oi, he's attacking our... Oh my god, that's a one-star brute.
Okay, oh wow, he did a lot of damage to us. Let's just carry him around in a circle. Get our shield out. There we go.
So I did think the Brutes of the Shaman did come in one and two stars. I think it's just rare that you see them. I think they've got quite a low chance of spawning. So it's quite rare that you see them. I don't think I've ever seen a two-star Brute. Jesus Christ, he almost killed us. That was a close battle. Wow. But he did give us a lot of materials, so thanks very much. He gave us three eyes, even though he only had two.
That's a good logic from the game there.
I wonder where his third eye came from. But yeah, like I've said in a previous episode, it is possible to get one and two star variants of pretty much every creature aside from bosses, and then there's a couple of other creatures that don't have them. You always have to be careful. I would definitely say in the next biome that we're headed to after the Black Forest, that's when damage and difficulty really start to ramp up. It really, really starts ramping up as you progress further and further through the game, so be prepared. It's not always gonna stay as easy as it's looking right now. I don't consider myself to be that amazing of a gamer, so there's probably going to be a lot more deaths on this playthrough. Some of them will be mistakes, and some of them will be silly moments, and some of them will just be because I get overwhelmed. Weight of numbers and difficult enemies are the two main reasons. Bosses I'm not too concerned about. I've done most of the bosses a lot of times, so I'm pretty confident with the majority of them. Unless, of course, they decide to start adding in higher difficulty versions of them. Something else I've mentioned previously, like maybe more difficult versions of the bosses. If they bring those in, I might struggle. But for the majority of them, I'm pretty confident taking them on. And I will try and do the same thing as I did during Ikthyr's boss fight, which is I'll try and give you a showcase as to their abilities and how they do the fight, so you can kind of see it as more of a walkthrough of that fight as well. Some of them can be a bit challenging. Some of them you just need to learn their different attacks and what to do to avoid these different attacks. Don't get me wrong, it's not like Dark Souls where you have to literally learn like all the different attack patterns and swings. It's not like they've got 100 different attack types and you have to try and recognize them from one subtle movement. Like it's a lot more simplistic than that when it comes to combat, especially with bosses. But some of them can still be quite a challenge. They do deal high amounts of damage and have really high health bars, so it is more of an endurance test more than an actual avoidance test, but you can avoid the majority of attacks as well, so... Oh wow, we've got a little Grey Dwarf party outside. He's celebrating the... Oh, that guy was sneak... We got sneak crit on that guy, that was weird. And to be fair, I think because we were behind the walls, he couldn't tell we were here, so when I jumped over the wall and just hit them, one of them wasn't aware of me. Guess maybe he was stood behind his friend, he just didn't see me. The sneaking and the awareness in the game is a bit, not bugged, but is a bit, sometimes it just doesn't, like, you'll be stood right next to an enemy and he just won't be aware of you, and you'll be able to get that first hit as being a sneak attack on them. It just happens. It's not very, like, frequent that happens, but it can happen. Right, I think, what are we going to do with this boat? Should we sail it back, or should we... We'll probably sail it back. I might explore a little bit further. Come on, wind. Give us a push. Give us a bit more speed. Thank you. Well, that didn't really increase our speed very much at all, but oh well. Sometimes boat sailing can be a bit frustrating, especially later on in the game when you've got the third level of boat, the next one. It can be very frustrating when you're trying to turn around, because obviously it's a lot bigger, and it's a bit more cumbersome to turn, and it grounds really easily.
I think we'll sail along this coast and explore a bit more of it, just in case there's anything out of the ordinary here. Obviously, if we could locate some early swamp biomes, that would be a really nice, or a really quick way of being able to have some initial swamp areas to visit. We haven't seen any yet. Honestly, the best way to tell biomes, obviously the easiest way to tell biomes is just to be right by the coast, so you can see the colour of the ground and types of trees and stuff like that. But for the majority of like the early biomes, like the first three or four, the best way to, well, obviously the your first three of them. So the fourth one is the mountains. So the mountains are easy to find. If it's if it rises up into the sky like a massive giant mountain, then it's a mountain. But for like meadows, black forest, and swamp, you can easily tell them from a distance when you're sailing. Even if you're not by the coast, you can still tell them from a distance by the trees, because the swamp has a very distinct type of tree as well. I'll be able to point those out once we eventually find some. Not exactly sure when we're going to get on to doing the Elder. It's not very long, it's not very far away now. Literally all we really have to do now is just go and build weapons and shields, stuff like that, from our bronze, and upgrade armor, stuff like that. But other than that, there isn't really much else left for us to do. There's a couple more things we need to build. There is we need to build a keg or a barrel. That's something we need to build. We unlocked that when we got the fine wood, when we first unlocked that. So we do need to build one of those so we can start making some of the meads and the potions. But other than that, and the armor upgrades and weapons and stuff, there isn't much left for us to do in the Black Forest now. Might need to gather some more Sirtling cores, but that is the reason why we've got portals and we're leaving them up. That's why I moved that portal to the northern Black Forest area in the last episode, was that I believe there's going to be a lot more burial chambers in that zone, so I want to keep it there so that we can find them. We will mark them on the map as well, so if we decide to explore the Elder's Island a bit more, we will mark on the map if we find any burial chambers, just so we're going to need them in future, so we can come back and clear them out really quickly. Just going to do a quick circumference of the island and check out what's around here. Yeah, I was correct, it is separate from our main island. Okie doke, that's fair enough. It's not separated by a lot. You could probably raft across this, to be fair, if we still had the raft. So it wouldn't be too difficult, but at least we found it, and at least we know building the portal was a good idea. Although I wouldn't want to sprint back to the Elder if we died anyway. Like, there'd be quite a long trek. So, and it's better that we've got the portal up, makes it nice and quick. Yeah, I think we're just going to sail along the coast and explore a bit more of our starting island.
I have to say, the amount of ore we got from this Black Forest biome, considering how small it is, the one that's connected to the mountain, the one that we spent ages mining, you can see on the map where our boat is, like this small piece of Black Forest that's right in front of us, I'm amazed at how much ore we managed to get from it. We pretty much got all the ore we were going to need for the rest of the playthrough, pretty much. I'd say we might need a bit more later on. We won't know for sure until we've actually turned it all into bronze and crafted all the stuff we need. There might be a couple of bits and pieces like bronze nails, you know, maybe a couple of kegs or something later on, possibly, that we might need it for. But yeah, I'm really surprised that this small little biome had all of that for us. But one thing we would have noticed, or one thing we did notice, was the fact that it didn't have any of the burial chambers or crypts, because it was connected to the side of a mountain and then right by the coast as well. So it's just kind of this thin, snaky, like, spit of Black Forest that just runs along the edge of the coast. But yeah, I was just really surprised at how small it was, but how much value we got from it and how close it was to our base as well. We really picked a good location for our base. I really do enjoy the location of our base, right on the coast, but it's right next to three mountains, but also has enough Black Forest nearby that we can walk to and from it. And yeah, it's just fantastic. I think it's really going to give us some value for the rest of the playthrough now. And now that we've got the Elder Portal set up, that should make traveling a bit further out a bit quicker as well. One mistake I have made, and I should have mentioned this earlier as well, is that we're sailing back. Now, the reason I'm sailing back rather than just knocking the boat down and taking its materials through the portal is that I wanted to explore and to see if the islands were connected or not. So obviously now we know 100% that these two islands aren't connected and we're going to have to either portal or sail here every time. But that is the quicker way of doing it, which for most other traveling we probably will do when it comes to moving the boat somewhere. Say if we want to go to the Elder but sail north to find some swamp or any future biomes, it'll be much easier for us to just knock the boat down. Say if the boat's back at home, we could knock the boat down with our axe, pick up all the pieces of it and take it back through the portal. Like I said, with materials that you can take through the portal, you can pretty much take anything through the portal except for ores, metal bars, and there's a few other later game materials that you can't take through, but they all have that little symbol on them, on their icon, that tells you that you can't portal with them. So you can take the bronze nails that you'll need to build your boat, to build the carve. You can take the leather and the wood. So as long as you've got the carry weight, it's easy. I do love the way the sailing looks in this game. It's just some beautiful imagery that you can get when you're sailing along, especially with the reflection of the sun from the surface of the water. Well, at least one thing I have been thinking about is I might turn the bloom down on the actual sun when it shines off the surface, and the moon as well, because it can be quite bright sometimes. I do apologize if it's blindingly bright. I should probably put a warning on the description of the video or something, just saying, see, there's some occasional moments of blinding brightness from the sun reflecting off the surface of the water. It's realistic, don't get me wrong. It looks really nice. I love the way the water looks at the minute, especially with the shadows and the bed of the ocean? The bed of the water, the underground? And with the rocks and all the tree stumps and stumps of the tree trunks and stuff like that on the ocean floor. But it just can be a bit bright with the sun glaring off it. That happens in the mountain as well sometimes. Obviously sun glaring off snow is very, very bright, so can be blinding at times. Oh, thought we were going to make it over that without grounding. God damn it. Oh well. It's just a shame that the wind is against us. This trip would be a heck of a lot quicker if it wasn't. And put a quick marker down here, because I can see there's a whole bunch of more silver nodes right there. If we ever need them in future, we've got them marked. Similar to that other island that we discovered a bit further up, which had loads of silver on it when we were sailing back to pick up our corpse a few episodes back. I didn't put a marker down for that one, but I remembered it being there when we needed the silver. nodes, so I just want to mark this one. So obviously we don't really need it right now, so it's something that, just in case I need it in future, I can always pop back. Did I say silver or tin? I meant to say tin nodes. Can't remember if that's silver or not.
Brain fart.
Pretty well timed as well, actually. Seeing how dark it's getting. Sky's going navy blue, it's going pretty dark, so it's getting pretty close to nighttime. Hopefully we can time it pretty right, get home and stick some more tin onto smelt, and then we can go to bed and sleep through the night, and that should skip that smelting. Just about got the wind in our sail as well.
It'll give us a little bit of a speed bonus, but not too much.
I know that when you're looking up speeds for boats, most guides will say there's only three different speeds. There's your oar speed, the rudder speed, or your when you're using the oars. And then there's half sail speed and then full sail speed. But I'm fairly certain that at full sail, when the wind is against the boat like this, where it's kind of blowing at the front, but you can still get benefit from it, I swear that's a slightly faster speed than normal, but not as fast as it would be if the wind is behind you. I could be wrong about this. This is something I've been thinking on quite a bit recently, because I've done quite a lot of sailing in the recordings. It might be that speed you're getting is the speed of the half sail rather than the full sail, but because the full sail's out, you're only getting that because the wind's still against you. I don't know. I'd have to look into it a bit more. I wouldn't know how you'd be able to test, like how to test it and work it out. Maybe, or, you know, you could do, I suppose. You could have two boats going against each other, but then I just don't know how you'd work it out. You'd have to have like a few different people and different boats and have them all at the same like half sail and full sail and stuff like that and see which is quicker. Yeah, you could do that. So like if we had another boat right next to us now, one at half sail, one at full sail, and see what speeds they go. I still think the full sail would be quicker, but again, I could be wrong because the wind is technically blowing to our side, not behind us, so we're only just getting the benefit from the wind. And the disadvantage of doing that as well is that it is, as you can see, our boat is leaning to the left because the wind is blowing us that way. So your boat will slowly, very, very gradually, very slowly be kind of being pushed to the left and slowly gliding to the left. So you do have to kind of keep turning the boat in some instances to compensate for that. Oh, we've just ticked into nighttime. We'll quickly craft a torch because we've got the materials, just so we can at least see the boat. And I think this is our final turn. Yep, we're on the final stretch and the wind is right behind us. That's very nice. That should give us a bit more speed. Should get us there slightly quicker. I think once we'll get back, we'll probably get the smelters going and then we'll probably just go to bed, sleep through the night, and we'll probably end the episode there. Again, it's been about half an hour, so I don't want everyone to run too much longer. There isn't much more for us to do on this session, so yeah, we'll probably end it very soon. Just gotta pull the boat into the non-existent harbour. I guess something else we need to do as well. I haven't done it yet, but it's something I am thinking of doing, which is building a proper harbour for our boats, especially if we have to build a third and a fourth level of boat. If there's two more boats to build, it might be worth building some kind of dock system. I guess I've just been a bit lazy with this playthrough. There's a lot of stuff we could build, and I just haven't done it, so I don't know. Maybe when we reach like a higher level, when we've reached a point where, you know, we're quite high level and we've got like a bit of time to kill, we can do stuff like that then. So that way, gathering all the materials and stuff like that for it will be a lot quicker. And then I could even have a few more of the Let's Build episodes, because we've got one of them so far, which was the circular crafting room that we built. I say circular. The crafting room that we built, we have that as a separate video. We could probably make a couple more. So like, oh, let's build a harbour or a dock, or let's build, I don't know, a big warehouse or something like that. Or a base in the plains, because we are going to need a base in some of the other biomes for some of the reasons why we need to be there. There we go. We are back. Let's gather up all of this copper. Dump it in the chest. Should we put some more on, or are we just going to go straight to bed? I think we might just go straight to bed. Right, we are going to call the episode here, so thank you everybody for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this one. We finally got our portal set up on the Elder, so we should be able to go and see him rather soon once we've got our upgrades and our new weapons and stuff. But yeah, thank you everybody for watching, I hope you've enjoyed, and I will catch you in the next episode.